This is super easy.
If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now.
What's up guys, I'm Rob. Welcome to my channel. Now a lot of you have been requesting that I make a tutorial on how to spin a pen because I make tutorials on this channel. But you know that I also make vlogs on my new channel called Rob in the Hood. So you can subscribe to that if you want to know a little behind the scenes of my life. And I also have two Instagram pages. So you can follow me there too so that you can connect with me or send in your requests. But before I teach you guys how to spin a pen, let's look at this cool montage. There you go, looks cool, right? So quickly grab a pen, pencil, marker, or anything you want to spin, and let's get into this. Get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Alright guys, let's get started. So today I'm going to show you guys how you can spin a pen or a pencil or a marker. Anything you want to spin, the technique is the same. But the important thing is, use something that you're comfortable holding. So if you use a pencil a lot, don't just switch to a marker, which is slightly wider or thicker, or to a pen, because it has a lot more weight than a pencil. Similarly, if you use a pen a lot, then don't switch to a pencil, because pencil is a lighter tool, or switch to a marker. Basically, use something that you're comfortable holding, you use every day, because that helps a lot, right? So the key thing is your grip or how you hold it, and that is what I'm gonna teach you guys today. Personally, I feel you should start with something that has a heavier end. So a pen always has a cap on one end, which basically adds a little more weight to it. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys how this works and how I hold the pen. So this is how I hold the pen. I hold it slightly from the top and not from the middle, like that. The weight, like I mentioned, is at the bottom. I don't hold it this way. You can also spin it this way, but I feel personally that holding it like this works better. So when you hold it and when you start, hold it in this way, where you have three fingers down and your thumb on top. Once you get the position, you can actually release the middle finger. You don't need this finger then, so you can release this. And now your grip is basically your thumb, your index finger, and your ring finger. You can release this finger like that. Now apply pressure. You're pushing this pen upwards and just keep this as a stopper. You can see the pen is just resting on the edge. So when I just release this finger, the pen automatically spins upwards, right? Also, what helps is if you rest your hand on like a surface, like a table, because then your thumb remains flat and acts like a base or an axis where the pen is going to spin, like that. So you can do it slowly, applying a little bit of pressure, because if you apply too much pressure, the pen will fly away. So you have to keep in mind the pressure you're applying, just enough that it spins on this axis, like that, and lands back in the same position. Then all I do is just slide it down to get back to my start position, and I spin it again. Looks pretty cool, right? So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna show you guys in slow motion, so you can actually see, because when you actually spin it fast, it looks cool. But you can't tell what I'm doing here. So let's watch this in slow motion. So now this is the basic technique. All you need to do is practice. And like I said, you can do it with any tool you like. So you can use a pen or you can use a pencil. A pencil, you can do it both ways. Just keep in mind that you keep one end longer and then it's easier to spin. You can also do it the other way, like this. It looks pretty cool because as soon as you spin it, you get it in the writing position. You can use a mechanical pencil. Again, you can try both sides, keeping the eraser end, which is the heavier end, at the bottom, like this, or the heavier end on top, so that you get in the writing position, like this. You can also do this with markers. So here you can see I have my Posca markers, and I've been spinning the Posca markers quite a bit for my DIY videos, And that's how some of you guys saw and you asked me to make a video on how I do this flourish or this pen spinning action. And obviously you can do this with a fatter marker also. The technique remains the same. All you have to do is change your grip a little bit and you have to change the pressure you're applying. So depending on the tool you're using, if it's a heavier tool, you'll have to apply a little more pressure. And if it's a lighter tool like a pencil, then you have to apply less pressure. So there you go. That's how you can spin a pen or a marker in this case. Now, I'm not really good at it, but I enjoy spinning a pen or a marker when I'm thinking or when I'm taking a break. It's like my own fidget spinner. And like I said, you can do it with any tool you like, with a marker, pencil, a pen, a mechanical pencil, whatever you like. You have to keep in mind that you have to practice a lot to get a nice spin. You will drop the pen or a marker a lot in the beginning, but that's how you learn. So just get the grip right and understand how much pressure you need to put for it to do a nice clean spin. And once you get the hang of it, this is really addictive, and you will leave your fidget spinner aside and you'll start working with these. So enjoy. So there you go, guys. That was my method of how you can spin a pen. Now, obviously there are a lot of different ways, techniques, variations, but I find this one easy and it's simple to start with. So I really hope it works for you. If you have any tips and tricks that will help me do this better, you can surely let me know in the comments below. I'm also trying to learn how to spin the pen backwards so I can spin it front and back and I can keep doing it continuously. If I learn it, then I'll make a tutorial on that too. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, like it, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, thank you. You are awesome. And that's it. I'll see you guys in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.